African pressure for Kenyatta's release. When the Kenya African National now threatened the peaceful transfer of power that Britain wanted. So, in August 1961, Governor Rennison bowed to the inevitable. Jomo Kenyatta, the man he had called the leader to darkness and death, returned home to a tumultuous welcome. After his release, Kenyatta accepted the presidency of KANU, a party whose radical platform was a near certainty to take over when Britain left.